Bro, block, and I have that so much easy. Like, what the fuck is wrong with y'all?
A loss of a yard, and it brings up four. Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it and absorbed it anyway.
God damn it.
Yeah, that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And two interceptions already here in this first half. Well, that's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
And that's the big fella's M.O. right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. This defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
Yardage here, going down back at the 28. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Let's go.
They run play action for Howard. Now Trubisky. Able to get away. Pressure too great, and he goes down. Linval Joseph forcing his way through there to drop him for a loss of a good 10 yards. Let's see what they draw up here. Third and long following the sack of Trubisky. From the gun, it's Trubisky. He's going deep for Brown.
There you go, Mike Hughes.
Time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Hughes. So that is three interceptions.
Probably better than a fucking punt.
And you hate to ask the question, but here, let's be honest. We're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here. But he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
Good starting field position for the Vikings as they have it first and 10. After the interception, here's Taylor.
God fucking damn it.
Taken down, a bear sack. Cameron Jordan in there to drop him, and his great season continues. 13 sacks for him now on the year. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. From the shotgun, it's Taylor. Yeah, this is
Doug Baldwin. Doug Baldwin.
Football. That one goes for 24 yards.
I don't care how many times you tell the story, it never loses its luster for me. Doug Baldwin, undrafted, out of Stanford, and plays like a number one receiver should in the NFL. I don't care how you cover him. I don't care that his size isn't great.
Poe disappear?
Comes up with the football.
Absolutely. His roots go all the way back to Gulf Breeze, Florida, where he's from, right on the water near Pensacola, and then, of course, to Stanford, and boy, he's been good. Second down, Taylor. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. A good pickup there, a 22. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass, that's complete. And he will score.
No, not Doug Baldwin, God damn it.
Second touchdown on the season, and the Vikings are able to strike for six. Extra point by Carlson, up and
God
good.
Damn it.
And that makes the score 14-7. Carlson now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Bears offense ready to take over again. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. Sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. It's a gain of 8, and it's going to take us to the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Soldier Field following this short break.
What?
Here's a second.
What are you talking about? I'm totally going to get it.
The chains. First down now, but that clock rolling. They'll throw on first down with Trubisky. To the right side, complete to Miller. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10. The Bears moving hastily.
Oh, he's that good.
Offense.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. And some space here, and he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Certainly making his presence felt in both the pass and the run game. He's having an impact.
Yeah, and his first carry of the game right there. He had hurt him with his arm. Now he's showing that he can shuffle the puppies as well. From midfield now, here's Trubisky. Quick hitter here, it's complete. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation.
Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down.
He's probably not faster than Lorenzo Carter, no.
Get whistles and a timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head to
Well, Lorenzo Carter has 88 speed.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Play action. It's Trubisky. He's going to air one.
Bro, if y'all can stop getting fucking torched, dear God. The same play, too. My God, y'all just got to stop getting torched.
Second touchdown of the game and his ninth on the year. And the Bears are an extra point away from tying the football game. Parkey adds the extra point. And we've got a tie game here in a back-and-forth first half. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This fielded at the 2. And an elegant run. And a nifty return there as he's all the way up past the 40-yard line.
But that return gives him a golden opportunity to go out in front. How will the
defense respond after giving up that type of a return?
And we'll get our first update of the afternoon from the Meadowlands. And an early advantage in that one for the Giants. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10. From the gun, it's Taylor. It's complete to Jerron Brown. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A good pickup there, a 22. And he'll take it down to the 30-yard line. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. It's Taylor. His throw caught at about the 5. Now the Bears will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. Fairly minimal pickup. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. They'll try to sneak with Taylor. Now he will take this one into the end zone for a Viking touchdown. Tyrod Taylor with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Vikings are going to take the lead. And he knocks it through. Carlson. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
A little over 20 seconds remaining in the half as they'll line up here first and 10. Now Trubisky. Forced out to his left. Now he's going to throw deep back. And that's caught inside the 35. And all the way down to the 29. A big play there just before halftime. 46 yards. So we've come upon it. And just like that, on we head to half number two. Okay, coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
The fight for the NFC North.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. And on the ground they go with a running back. So we got 3 and 1 tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Tackle is made by Cameron Jordan.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people,
hard to get them started again occasionally.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Oh my God, dude. Wow. Bro, you have got to push through harder than that. Oh man, if only I had my starting running back or my backup running back or my starting wide receiver or my backup wide receiver. But alas, all four of them are hurt.
Just 33 following a 10-yard return, and the Bears take over. So here are the Bears now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively, and now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because no, tell me.
That's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker boards?
Yeah, those two.
Gotta go.
Swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down. Here's Pat O'Donnell now, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. The Vikings offense.
So who won the NFC?
Out to take over.
This was still playing.
Last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you
can take the field position. It's cute.
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
God, I had him. Fuck.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here.
Yes, I am, Earl. I'm here, Earl. How are you?
And a nice gain there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20. 8 yards on the run there, and that trims it to a third and 11.
I have 7 minutes left on my down low.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Hey, Mo. Yo, what are these balls here?
On third down, Taylor.
Get by curtains and blinds.
Oh my God. If this game isn't the worst thing ever, why do I have a 94 overall tight end?
At their own 48-yard line. He was looking for
Jesus fucking Christ.
Trubisky brings the Bears up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48.
Oh, trigger alert.
They go with Howard to begin the drive. And he's going to take this one down inside the 45.
What PSS?
And it'll be second down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
They go with Howard again. And an alley to run. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? Second and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package was that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned it. But his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Harrison Smith.
Are y'all serious?
When I saw the pressure coming at him, that just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure on the face of a guy, and can he step into
yes.
a crowd? And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions are
so good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 in your hometown of Orlando, Florida.
I took my ball down there and grabbed me a beverage.
Here now is second and 10.
Let me turn this damn heater off, too. God damn, it's probably 79,000 degrees up here. Shit. That's cold this morning. That's
terrible. Again, now it's Taylor on second and 10.
Oh, okay. Oh man, I hate playing these games. I can't do anything on offense.
Even longer, they're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Third and long, Taylor and company hoping to regroup after the sack. Play action, now Taylor. It's complete to Laquan Treadwell. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Try the ground game here with the running back. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. 25 yards to pick up there and also a first down.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously, but at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
Trailing in the fourth this close of a game, that's a penalty you just can't afford.
It's an absolute killer, and it's one that drives coaches and teammates insane.
Now it's first and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. And he'll get in! Touchdown! Minnesota, a great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Vikings find a way to stretch their lead. And he's able to put it through. Charles, this one, not over, certainly, but you set the magic number earlier in this game at 20 points, said that they would need to hold them right around that marker under it. What are you seeing here?
Well, that number is still in play because we said, okay, 20 or under gives them a chance to win, right on pace for being in that range, and guess what? They've got a shot.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Interception. They've been around the ball all game.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick. Pressure comes, and Trubisky goes down. Sheldon Richardson in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year.
Lock it.
Now Trubisky on 3rd and long. And oh, they almost had another one. They are all over the football in this game. Nearly another pick. Now 4th down.
It's never a bad idea to try and get it to Antonio Brown, but there must be a little bit of the Madden curse going on for our cover athlete here. Hasn't been able to get that elite separation that we're used to seeing from him.
Now Trubisky to throw. He gets it to Brown. Good play. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on 4th down. From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack back at the 47-yard line.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness of that defensive line is eating them alive.
Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. A good pickup there, a 22.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz.
And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there, back at the 39-yard line.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. 6 sacks given up in this one.
They go play action. Trubisky. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter. The Bears on 3rd down. Just 1 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 4. They'll run it now out of the gun. Oh, good move. He'll have a first down inside the 10. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. A great play there. His 9th touchdown of the season. And the Bears have cut it to within a score. Parkey with the extra point. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this 4th quarter. Here's Parkey now, set to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a 1-score game. And you hear a lot about 2-minute offense and 4-minute offense. Obviously, the 4-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the 4-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for 1st and 10. Taylor
they're going to run the option right. And hell, running right through it. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper. Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he's got across midfield.
Damn, heroin's one hell of a drug.
3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
Let's have a moment of silence for PSG fans. My Rainbow's downloaded. I have enough time to play a game on Rainbow and then go eat. But Austin's not here, so there's no going to beat on Rainbow.
Off the play fake. Here's Taylor.
I could cook up a little something now. Yeah. No, we don't serve a bocce, but, I mean, we got the walk, though. It's a big-ass damn pot that them Asian cooks be cooking in.
As he's on to kick it away. And he gets this
that shit, yeah.
This is a good one.
Get hot.
Oh,
I know what you're talking about. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. That's what are we cooking in front there, cooking on the flat side? No, we ain't got that there.
Last time out to get into the end zone, and with this starting field position, they're going to have to...
Yeah, we got... Yeah, you can get shrimp fried rice and get all the type of rice you want, but it's not cooked. It's the same thing. Only it's hibachi because they cook it on the flat top in front of you. That's the only difference. But yeah, all the shit that they do, you can literally get at where I'm at. Plus and sushi.
Escape the shadow of their goalpost. That helped 10 yards. First down.
You can get white rice, you can get brown rice, or you can get fried rice. And then if you don't want like all the like the bean sprouts and the peas and carrots and stuff in your fried rice, you don't have to get it in there. You tell them what you want, and they'll be cooking it right then and there. So however you want it is how we got to cook it.
Executed well there.
And it's often hard after you played really well early, and then you kind
of people go in there a lot of times. They're going to get like a fried rice. They'll get like a fried rice base, which is like $5 more. But you get a fried rice base and put whatever meat you want in it and shit like that. And or what people do is a base thing that you like the fried rice chicken, fried rice shrimp, fried rice chicken, add the extra shrimp. You can get it how you want, with steak too, get with steak in it. We got the sushi bar where you can, we got like almost all of our rolls, you can put them in the fryer if you want to fry the damn roll, make it a damn a crunch roll or whatever kind of roll you want to make it. These niggas on a motorcycle or some BK, some UK niggas.
Back to throw. Safety valve here. That's complete. And past the 40. That time and a new set of downs. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts.
It's going down.
As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game.
Houston, Atlanta, Vegas is overrated.
The drive continues as they search for a
tight touchdown. Is.
Here's first and 10. Back to throw. And a flag comes in as that one falls in.
Take care, overrated.
Let's see who this is on. In the pocket, chucked it away. Flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are in the field. Have some awareness.
Take care. Take care, overrated. Take care, overrated. Take care. Nah, I ain't say take care. Nah. No, yeah. I thought great, dude.
Sheldon Richardson in there to take him down.
I fuck all great bitches.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again.
to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far.
Oh my God.
Need something from deep in the back.
Bryce, I take great pride, just like Shark, in giving you your only loss. Like he gave me my only loss.
Here's Trubisky.
In this 2K league. I didn't know you was hooping like that with a boy. You got hit hooping. I said, shout out to you hooping, though. Hooping with the Blazers. You 5-1, too. I see you.
As expected, they're going for it to
you still down by 7 in that game?
It got his man complete.
Jesus Christ.
And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead.
I was literally going to get on there to play a game before I eat, but now I'm on 2K just chilling practice alone. But definitely after I get done eating, I'll hop on there. Tyler probably will play then if he's not getting off to go to his lady friend's house.
No, man.
So the big play moves him all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45.
Zach LaVine just will dunk on anybody. I fucks with that.
Left side taken in by Miller. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
I do appreciate doing business with your boy Mark Chester.
That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds.
Hey, it took 6 hours of me literally sitting here on PlayStation while they were at work trying to get this shit to work, to get all three trades, get it all green light, and with all of us agreeing on something. Shit was an interesting process.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Trubisky to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. These are the spots, this stage of the game, where it pays to have speed on the perimeter, doesn't it?
It certainly does. And in the second quarter, he may very well run by him. But in this situation, I know as a defender, I'm loosening up a couple of extra steps that allowed him to run with him stride for stride.
Line on second and 10.
Oh, he just hard.
Now it's Trubisky.
Jesus, this really is coming down to the fucking last goddamn play.
It's going to be up to basically a goal line, a stop.
No,
or,
this is
or
the
down.
Last play. There's 2 seconds left, and he's on the goal line.
A looming decision to make on the conversion, down 7. But first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. One last shot for Trubisky. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Von Bell.
Sounds like Bryce came up short.
And he's into the clear. He's at the 50. 30.
Would you take my experience? I had to do that.
It's a touchdown.
I don't know.
It's only what. Bryce, I'm done after the season, so it's over. Let's go. Unless you playing season 5, Bryce, or
you're right, it's blatantly disrespectful.
What'd you do? Did you throw a bomb?
No, he threw a pick on the last play, and I took it all the way. I would have done that to anyone.
Mm-hmm.
I won't anyway.
You're getting a little V-curve.
Maybe I'll finally win one now. DJ, you really not playing the playoffs?
Nope. no point. I'm done with that game. I ain't played in like 4 or 5 weeks while I play now.
True.
What, y'all, you just don't, I'll delete it right now. I'll do a Matt and just delete the game.
Matt already deleted it?
Yeah, Matt already deleted it. That's what someone like sent. They're like, hey, you want to play whatever, Matt? It's like, I'm done. Like, the game is like, I play you next season cause, or next Madden because he's deleted. I'm like, yep, I can feel you.
Ricky! All right, I'll get on Rainbow in a second.